In this video, we will talk about heart sounds. Let's get started. First, let's quickly revise some basic points. The heart has two atria and two ventricles. The valves between the atria and ventricles are called atrioventricular valves. Their cusps are attached to chorda tendini, which in turn are attached to papillary muscles of ventricles. The valves between ventricles and the major arteries are called semilunar valves. Talking about the cardiac cycle now. Broadly, there are two phases of the cardiac cycle, ventricular systole and diastole. Systole includes isovolumetric contraction and ejection phase, and diastole includes isovolumetric relaxation, rapid filling, diastasis, and atrial systole. Now let's begin our discussion of heart sounds. Four heart sounds are produced at different times during a cardiac cycle. These are first heart sound, second heart sound, third heart sound, and fourth heart sound. Among them, the first and the second heart sounds are the major or physiological heart sounds. They can be heard with a stethoscope. The third and fourth heart sounds are heard only occasionally. Normally, they are not audible with a stethoscope and can only be recorded with a phonocardiogram. Now let's see the detail of each heart sound one by one, starting with the first heart sound. We know that at the beginning of the systole, the atrioventricular valves close. The first heart sound is associated with that. Initially, it was thought that the sound is produced due to slapping together of the leaflets of the valve. However, the fact is, the blood in between the leaflets cushions the slapping. So actually, little or no sound is produced due to the slapping effect. It is similar to why clapping your hands inside water does not produce sound. Now, if that is not the cause, what produces the sound? The answer is the vibration of taut valves and adjacent walls of the heart. See, during diastole, the atrioventricular valves are open. Then, at the beginning of the systole, the contraction of ventricles causes sudden backflow of blood at atrioventricular valves. This causes the valves to close and bulge towards the atria. However, chorda tendini abruptly stops this back bulging motion of valves. So now, the blood that was trying to go back into the atria is bounced back into the ventricle. All this sets up vibrations in blood, valves, and ventricular wall. These vibrations travel through the adjacent tissues and are heard as sound. Again, the entire event is like this. One more time. Repeat the video if you are still not getting it. This heart sound resembles a spoken word lub. Its duration is about 0.14 seconds. So this was the first heart sound. Now let's study the second heart sound. It is associated with the closure of semilunar valves at the end of the systole. The mechanism behind this sound is somewhat similar to that of the first heart sound. At the end of the systole, the backflow of the blood closes the valves and makes them bulge into the ventricles. But the elastic stretch of the valves recoils the blood back into the arteries. This produces vibrations in blood, valves, and wall of large arteries, similar to how we saw for the first heart sound. These vibrations are transmitted in adjacent tissues and heard as second heart sound. This sound resembles a spoken word dub. Its duration is about 0.11 seconds. This duration is shorter than the duration of the first heart sound, which is 0.14 seconds long. The reason is the semilunar valves are more taut than atrioventricular valves. So they vibrate for a shorter time than do the atrioventricular valves. So this was the second heart sound. And that completes both the major heart sounds. Now the sounds that are heard occasionally are third and fourth heart sounds. The third heart sound is heard early in the diastole. It is produced by sudden inrushing of blood from atria into the ventricles. It can be heard physiologically in children and young adults. In older people, it's usually indicative of some pathology. When this third heart sound gets added to the physiological first and second heart sounds, the three sound sequence S1, S2, S3 sounds like a galloping horse. And it's called protodiastolic gallop or ventricular gallop. So that was the third heart sound. Now the final one, fourth heart sound. It coincides with atrial contraction. It's heard in pathological conditions in which ventricular compliance is decreased. Or in simple words, ventricles do not dilate easily. In such conditions, atria contract more forcefully to fill the ventricles, and this produces the fourth heart sound. When this sound is added to the first and second heart sounds, the resultant sequence S4, S1, S2 is also a galloping rhythm. This one is called presystolic gallop or atrial gallop. So these were the heart sounds. Now let's have a quick summary. The first heart sound coincides with the closure of atrioventricular valve at the beginning of the systole. It is produced by vibrations of blood, leaflets of atrioventricular valves, and the adjacent wall of the heart. The second heart sound is heard at the closure of the semilunar valves at the end of the systole. It is produced by vibrations in the wall of the major arteries. The first and second heart sounds are more prominent and can be heard physiologically with a stethoscope. Third and fourth heart sounds occur occasionally. Normally, they can't be heard with a stethoscope, and their presence is usually indicative of pathology. The third heart sound is produced at the beginning of the diastole due to sudden rushing of blood. The fourth heart sound is produced during atrial contraction, just before the ventricular systole. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.